Hello everyone, and welcome to another how-to video. My name is Oliver Draper, CTO for COP. And what we're going to look at today is how to set up a Hikvision NVR using the Hikvision Partner Pro app on the mobile phone. The Partner Pro app is the installer application you put on your phone, designed to basically manage your customer database as well as manage all the devices at each customer site. And then at that point, you can then hand the device over to the end user HikConnect app. So let's get into it and just see how easy this really is. Okay, so I've got a folder on my phone at the moment. So I'm just going to click on the Hik-Partner Pro app. This app can be downloaded from the Google Play Store as well as the Apple iStore as well. Now, on the local network that my Wi-Fi is connected to, I've already got an NVR straight out of the box and plugged in. As you can see, as soon as I open the Partner Pro app, it's found this NVR on the network, and it's telling me that it's inactivated, i.e. it's brand new, fresh out of the box. I have plugged one IP camera directly into the back of the NVR before starting. Obviously, they are plug and play ports, and of course, obviously, it's connected to the network. So it's giving me the option to activate the device, so I'll just click the button to activate, and it's asking me now to give the device a password of my choice. So I'm just going to tap in a password of my choice. I'm going to go with something nice and simple just for today's demonstration, which is going to be capital A, lowercase b, c, d, 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's just what I'm choosing to use. I'm also going to set that as the verification code. That's what we're going to use basically talk to the HikConnect and HikProConnect server. Once I've done that, I click next. As we can see, it's activated the device. It's now configuring the network details. So it's already pushed the password to the device to activate it. It's now in the process of setting up some network details. It's checked the firmware version. It's synced the date and time to my phone. And the hard drive is saying is already initialized. If it wasn't, it would have initialized the hard drive. Then click next. And that was it, done. It's actually activated and set up the device straight away. It's now given the option, obviously it's found other things on my device because it is using a built-in SADP tool. Is asking me which site I want to add it to. Do I want to add it to the existing site I've got or put it to a new site? So I'm just going to put it on a new site. I'm just going to call this one COP Office. Oh, I didn't spell that correctly. Okay, so COP Office will do nicely. That's the site I'm going to call it. That's the device I want to add to that site. So imagine you add other devices as well. You could add all these devices to it, but I'm just going to add the one at the top that we've just activated, and then I click OK. It's now adding that device to the site I just created in the Partner Pro app. So the way Partner Pro works is you create a site location, and then you add all the devices to that site location. So it makes it very easy to manage your customer bases and what devices are on each site. Okay, so it said it's added that device to that site, and it's now giving me an option for that particular device and site. So do I want to transfer this over, or do I want to share it to my end user? So transfer is where I would basically hand over the entire site over to the end user on the HikConnect app. I would still have permissions to configure live view and playback the devices, granted should I have the end user permission to do so. Alternatively, I can do share. Share is where, again, it hands over the device to the HikConnect app for the end user to have access, but they only get the operation permissions. I maintain the full configuration permissions, and I also have the facility to disable devices and do other various bits and pieces. However, we're not at this stage just yet, so I'm not going to transfer over the device. So I'm just going to hit complete in the top right-hand corner. So there's the device now. You can see at the top there, it says COP Office. It says it's not handed over because I've not handed over to anybody just yet. It's given the option to add some health monitoring there if I want to. Now, if we look at the bottom here, we can see that device just there at the bottom. I've got the option to go to the play button to actually play the live view. I'm going to need to put the verification code in there for the first time. That's what it's going to be asking for. There we go. So it's actually pushed the verification code now. So when I click the play button, there we go. I've got a camera plugged into port number 5. That's the only one I've got plugged in. And as we can see, we're getting an image there. Fantastic. Okay. If I go back, I've got the option to go to playback as well. So I can play back footage if I wanted to. I've got the option to add more IP cameras. So if I click the add button there, it's saying I can auto add. So it looks for cameras that are already on the network. Or I can click manual, where I manually add any cameras that it might not be able to find. And then I've got my IP details. As we can see, it is using DHCP. That's that dynamic host control protocol. This is where the recorder is called into my local router and asks for some IP details, and it's already assigned them. Alternatively, I can turn that off, and then I can manually assign the IP details for this device if I want to edit them at a later date. So pretty much, it's more or less set up and ready to go. Click the three dots in the top right-hand corner. Again, I've got all those various settings as well. I can reset the password for the device. I've got more settings there. If I go to more settings, as you can see, I've got more details, which I would get very similarly to what I would have on the web browser for the NVR. You don't get everything, you get the majority of things. So again, you get your basic network settings there. You got some advanced network settings as well. If I go to video and audio, click on the video and audio settings. Drop down there. Select the camera. It's already gone to put to D5 at the top, as we can see, because it detected that's the only one that's got a camera on. And here I can set up things like the resolution, the bitrate type, the maximum bitrate, the video encoding method. So I've got all the details on there. Display information stream, that's our dual VCA, that's already turned on as well. If I go to my image settings, again, I get the very basic image settings that you would do if you were on the NVR. I can configure my on-screen display settings as well, should I wish to, just as if I was locally on the NVR. Go to event, basic event. I can set up my motion detection on here. If I go to my smart event, again, same thing with the smart events. I can go to something like, for example, I don't know, line crossing detection. I can enable line crossing, go to area setting, and then I can choose my line crossing I want to put on there, wherever I want to actually do it. So to click draw area. And I'm just going to rotate my phone around. Hopefully this doesn't mess the video up too much. It's now asking me to where I can actually click and drag that, move that line should I wish to. Let's click OK on that one. So again, I can put that line wherever I want to and choose obviously human, vehicle, or both. Set my direction of travel. Is it A to B, B to A, or both directions? It's entirely up to myself. Let's click cancel on there. My arming schedule and also my linkage method. What do I want the actual system to do? When this triggers. And again, I've got the option there for obviously audio warning, voice prompting, trigger recording, trigger alarm outputs. These are all on there. And you can see all these settings, which you would get if you were actually locally on the NVR itself. I'm going to save that on there. Just make sure it is turned off because I don't want to save anything just yet. Okay, that's saved. Go back, top left. And then we obviously got our storage settings in there as well, as well as those are system settings at the top. So as you can see, we've got pretty much majority of the settings that you would need to actually configure the device. I'm doing all this from a mobile phone. I don't need to go to a customer site with a laptop or anything like that. I don't need to worry about plugging a monitor into the recorder and having to use a mouse to sort of click for the menus. I'm doing it all through my mobile phone. Now, once I've done all this, I've got a few other options as well. So at the minute the site has been created, it says COP Office at the top. If I click the three dots in the top right-hand corner, I can go to site details. And as we can see at the minute, there's a few things that need filling in. At the moment, we've got things like scene, address, and city. These are obviously not all been set yet. So I click the little pencil icon top right corner, and then I've got the option to edit some of these details, including the site name. I can click scene. What kind of scene is it? And this doesn't actually change any settings on the device's behavior or anything. This just is for my own reference, so I know what sort of premises this is. So I'm just going to click office. Address. Now, I can type in the address manually if I wanted to. However, you can see in blue to the right where it says address, I click set map, and then it opens up the mapping icon. It's used GPS location on my phone to say, where is this site? And I can just double check by scrolling in, and that is actually where we are. So I can set that position. I just click OK. I'm happy with that position. And as you can see, it's now populated the full address of the office on there, ready for it to go. Now, as we get down to the bottom, we've got our different time zones and things. And what I do like is this feature, sync time and time zone to device. So the Hik-Connect, Hik Pro Connect server is a cloud-based server. The one for UK and Ireland is actually in Ireland is where the servers actually physically are. Now, these are AWS servers, Amazon Web Solutions servers that these services are running on. When you tick that box there, it says time sync, time and time zone to device. What it will do is it will, whatever devices you add to this site location you've created, it will push Amazon's NTP server details to any devices you add in that site. So you never need to worry about date and time or having to manually change that. Again, it will be using Amazon's NTP services to ensure the time and date on the devices are staying correct. I just click OK at the bottom. I've now edited that site and that's all good to go. So if I just go back button there, as we can see, we've got all the information on there again, back where we were. Now, what's good about this is the fact that we've now edited all these details and obviously the site is now correct. If I go back to those three dots and go back to site details, you can see next to where it says address, it says map. If I click on map, it's showing me, of course, where that site actually is. And this will be the same for any site that we have in our Partner Pro app. But then I can click navigate at the bottom and then I can choose Google Map in my instance. And now what it's done, it's opened up the Google Map option for me to start navigating and driving to that location. Obviously, as we can see, we are currently on the same sites where this system is. So obviously it's not going to navigate me anywhere. But essentially what it's done there, I can now dock this phone in the cradle in my car and I use as a sat nav to get to my customer site. I don't have to worry about putting the address in manually or having to manually search for that one. So that's a really great feature for that one. So once you've set your device up and it's all running as it should be and you can see your devices there, and you might have added more devices in such as the NVRs and other cameras and video intercom, whatever devices they are. As you can see, top left corner, it's now saying not handed over. So again, it's not belonging to an end user. Now the end user needs this on their mobile phone to get access to it. That's why I have the button that says hand over site. And that will hand over the entire site, all the devices in there to the end user. As we can see, we can do share or transfer. I'm just going to go with transfer. And it's telling me all the details about saying after installation and configuration of devices are completed, you can hand over the devices to the customer by transferring. After the customer accepts the handover, the customer takes ownership. If you want to do anything with the device in the future, such as live view playback or remote config, you need to get permission from the end user and things like that. Even the customer has the facility to remove you as the installer from their system because end of day, it is their system they bought off you at end of the day. So now I'm just going to click OK on there. It's going to say, what permissions am I going to apply for at the point of handing over? So clearly I want configuration permission, I want live view, and I want playback. And I can choose how long I want this access for. Is it 1 hour? Is it 2 hours? Is it going to be the 4 hours, 8 hours? Or is it going to be permanent? And I can choose what permission I get. Now, this is an application for these permissions. Doesn't mean as soon as I click next, hand up to the customer, I'm going to get those permissions. Because what happens is the customer will receive a Hik-Connect notification saying the installer has completed installation and wants to hand the device over, and the end user has to accept that and also basically grant your permissions you asked for. So I'm now going to click Next. It's now going to say, do I want to hand it over by scanning the QR code or hand it over using the customer's email address or phone number? So if I already know their details that they've signed up with, again, I can just pop those in there by clicking phone or email, or I can get the customer with their Hik-Connect app to click the scan QR code and they scan that QR code that's on my screen now. However, I'm just going to go over handover via phone and email, and then I'm just going to go email because I know this one here. I'm just going to pop this one on here at the moment. I'm going to pop in my email address, pop that in there, click submit application. So that's now in the process of handing that over to the end user. It says a request for handover has been sent and the user will get a Hik-Connect notification accepting that one. So let's click OK. So we've now got the customer's details at the top there. And now if we go to the Hik-Connect app, we'll take a look and see what the customer has received. So as we can see on the Hik-Connect app, the customer has got a notification there saying you have one pending device handover application, view now. So I'm going to go view now and let's take a look. If I go toward the top to my system services, wait for those to load up. And as we can see there, I've now got a device handover authorization application and I can see the model number of the NVR underneath. So I'm going to click on that one. And it's saying COP UK, because that's who we are. That's what I set up on the app before. It says the service provider has completed installation, wanted to hand the device over. And that's the device to be handed over, or devices. There's only one there so far. I've got the option to reject and agree to that one. So I'm going to agree to accept that over. So that's now in the handing over process, and that's going to come over to me now. And it's now applying for permissions, and here we go now. So I can see what my installer has asked for at point of handing it over. They've asked for configuration, live view, and playback, and it's been permanent for everything. Now, I can turn around as the end user now and go, okay, that's fine, but I'm only going to give you an hour of live view and 1 hour of playback, because I know, actually, by the time you've that hour's expired, there should be no reason why you need the live view or playback after that. I'm going to give you permanent configuration permission, though, and now I click Agree. So now that's been authorized, click OK, and as we can see, my system is now there, and I will have access to the camera just like the end user did, so like the HikeConnect Partner Pro person did. Pop in the verification code. And there we go. We got my live view, just like the Partner Pro app had earlier on. So back in the Partner Pro app from the installer's point of view now, that device is now handed over. And we can see that device just there. If I just go back one, I can see all my various sites now that I've previously set up. And COP Office is there at the top. If I click onto that one there, again, I can see my devices. And I can see exactly what's going on with this system as well. Click on the cog button there. I can click into more settings and go into configuration of this device, because I've still got permission to do that. That's absolutely fine. Just like I've still got permission for live view and playback and everything else for the time being. Now, back in the Partner Pro app from the installer's point of view, as we know, that device has now been handed over to the end user now, so they've got access to it. I've still got my access, so if I click on the actual name of the device itself, I can see there the surname of the device, the model name, the device type. I can then do the reset password. If I click reset password, I've got the facility to reset the password, where the end user will be sent a notification prompting them to reset the password of the device. I never need to know what that password is going to be, because if the end user grants me permission via the application, then that will just automatically give me access through this app as well. If I look at the bottom, I've got my available permissions. I've got live view, configuration, playback. However, you'll notice on live view and playback, I've got a countdown going on there, because the end user, at point of receiving it, only granted me an hour of those. I can click on the three little dots there, and I can apply for permission, where I can basically say, actually, I want a longer permission than what I was already given. So I click on that device itself, and I'm setting what I want my permission for. Alternatively, click on the three dots, I can actually release permission, because I can say, well, actually, I've done everything I need to do now. I no longer need these permissions on your devices, so I can release permission back. If I ever do need it in the future, again, I could just apply for it. And at the top, as we can see, next to the device name, I've got that cog that we can see there. I've got the play button and the playback button. So I can click on the cog button and, again, as I did previously, go back into the settings of this device. Now, from the end user point of view, back on the HikeConnect app, yes, I've got access to the device now as an end user, but at the bottom, you've got these four icons. The new one that will appear is the one that says services with a little heart on it. If I click on there, that shows me my service provider, my installer. And as we can see there, we've got the installer's name, we've got the phone number of the installer, the website, the email address, and the location as well. So all those details are there. At the bottom, I can click on the actual, it says already provided services for one time. I can click on there and see any notifications that's taking place with any devices I've got. I got the option there to authorize more. So if I've got any more devices in my HikeConnect app, I can just go, oh, I've already got a new device now. There you go. I'm going to grant that to my installer so they've got access to that device if they need to do any maintenance. At the top, we've got the option there for authorization service, and it says three devices. So I click on there. My installer has got access to these three devices, the new NVR we've just recently added in, my home NVR, which is on there, and my AX Pro alarm system. Now I can click on the actual NVR that I've got there, and I can see, again, my installer's details and also the permissions my installer currently has. And I can edit those at any point by clicking the edit button, and I can relinquish these permissions from my installer should I need to, or change the permissions that they have over these devices. So when I'm back at the main page, where it says my service provider, if I click on where it says COP UK, let's take a look. Yes, I've got all the details there of my installer and what device they've got access to. And as we can see, where it says COP Office, I can click on the three little dots there, and I can change some things about this one. I can change the site name. I can edit the permissions, authorize more devices, transfer the device from my HikeConnect app to another HikeConnect app. So it might be that I'm relinquishing the device altogether and handing the site to another HikeConnect user, or cancel authorization. I can choose to revoke the authorization of my installer so they no longer have access to my devices, because they are my devices at the end of the day. So it's up to me who has access to them. Obviously, I'm not going to do that right now because we're obviously still using the system. So there we go. Quite a useful app, the Hik-Partner Pro app, designed for installers to manage all their customer sites and devices at each site, getting full remote configuration, live view, and playback permissions all through the mobile phone without the need of using a laptop, PC, or even plugging a mouse and a monitor into the recorder as well. Now, there is a web browser for the Hik-Partner Pro application as well, because it is a cloud-based server. There'll be another video on that one showing you how you navigate for the web browser and some of the features you get in there as well. So do stay tuned to our social media platforms for that one. As always, if you like the video, don't forget to like it. Please do subscribe and press that bell icon. That way you'll be alerted when we launch any new videos.